Knowing somebody that you care about is struggling with depression can be really, really difficult, but there's a right and wrong way to help them. So in this video, we're gonna talk about 3 tips for helping someone you know who has depression. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from the Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. So this video is meant for 2 different people, right? So you might be someone who knows somebody struggling with depression and you do not know how to help. This video is for you. But you might also be someone who is struggling with depression and people in your life don't necessarily know how to help you, okay? And they probably do things that make you even more upset. So it is Mental Health Awareness Month, and that's one of the main reasons why I'm making this video now. Like, please do me a favor and share this video so more people are aware and they understand how to help somebody who is struggling with depression, all right? So let's get started. So tip number 1, this is the most important tip that I can give you. Okay, you do not have to fix them. Okay, let me repeat that. You do not have to fix them. This is extremely important, and here's why. A lot of people trying to help someone who has depression, you're thinking that you have to do something. You have to do something that will help them, that will fix them. And then what happens is a lot of times you start to get frustrated. You start getting frustrated about that person's mental illness, okay? And this, for lack of better words, it becomes a very selfish intention, right? You only want to help them so you feel better. But depression is a mental illness. You are not somebody who's just gonna swoop in and save the day. And this, just accepting this, is going to help you and your mental health greatly. As soon as you can accept the fact that you cannot fix them, things are gonna start getting easier and you'll start moving towards the right direction. Just remember, you're not a psychologist, you're not a therapist, you're not a doctor, but even still, even if you were, this is not the place to do it. For example, my mom is a psychologist. She does not help me with my mental health issues. There is a relationship there which makes it very hard to get an objective point of view. Now, if you wanna assist them by taking some of the load off or some of the anxiety that comes with like looking for a therapist or looking for other treatment options or looking for mental health YouTube channels like this one, like go ahead and do it if they're willing to accept the help, all right? Just stick your hand out there and offer to help them in any way that you can. But please, please, please remember, it's not your job to fix them. Tip number 2, listen. Just listen. That's it. That's it, okay? So a lot of times, and this ties into tip number 1, a lot of times you think just because the person is talking to you about their depression that they're asking you to do something. Like, before I made this video, I was kind of depending on how I was gonna do this this topic, right? And there was like lists of things you don't say to somebody with depression. I'm like, man, there's a lot of lists and they're pretty big lists. And the reason being is like a lot of people, when they're depressed, they're not in the right state of mind. So even though you have good intentions, saying certain things can actually make things worse. Most of the time, and this is coming from somebody who has struggled with depression for many years, most of the time I just need somebody to listen to me, someone to just be there for me. That's it. That's it, and it's hard. If you're the type of person who thinks that you have to fix everybody, it's hard to just listen. You wanna chime in and offer suggestions and all sorts of things, and that's cool. We love you, we appreciate you, but sometimes you just gotta sit back and listen. If you want to help somebody and not get yourself in trouble, here is a good rule of thumb to use, okay? Ask the person, ask them for their permission. Say, is there anything that I can do to help? Or say, would you like some suggestions? Ask that, because if they say yes, boom, doors open. They want some suggestions. They've hit a brick wall, they don't know what to do anymore, they want some suggestions from you. But they also have the opportunity to say no. Like, think about it for a second. Even if you're not struggling with depression, most of us do not like unsolicited advice, right? So why would it be any different for somebody else? So in this situation, just kind of reverse roles and say, okay, well, do I really want people to say things like, just cheer up, or why don't you go for a walk? Have you tried yoga and da-da-da-da-da, you know what I mean? So think about how that would affect you, and that'll help you kind of understand that there isn't much you can say in most situations. But if you ask permission and ask them if they want suggestions or if there's anything you could do to help, boom, you're good. And the 3rd final tip, this is something This is a term that I have coined called depression buddies, all right? So if you have somebody in your life who is struggling with depression, maybe it's a friend or a family member or something like that, right? What you can do is check in on them, okay? And this is a good habit to develop, but like listen to how we're gonna strategize this, all right? Like if you're hitting them up 20 times a day saying, are you okay, are you okay, are you okay, are you okay? Again, reverse the roles real quick. Would you want somebody asking you that 20 times a day? No, no you wouldn't, nobody would. So the best thing you could do is just check in with them. You know, let's say it's Monday. You check in with them and say, hey, just want to check in and see how you're doing. Gauge them, see how they're responding. Do they want to talk? Are they trying to brush you off? Are they like, I'm okay, I'm fine, whatever it is. Okay, feel them out. And then just remind them, hey, if you need anything, just let you know I'm here. Now, wait another day or 2 days, something like that. Give them time and then follow up with them again. Something that I use, okay, is my cell phone. I set reminders on my calendar to check in with people, all right? Because here's what happens far too often, all right? And this is what happened to a lot of my experience. Maybe somebody checked in with me, but when I'm depressed, I don't wanna talk to anybody, da-da-da-da-da, right? But with the way depression works is that maybe you checked in with me once and I didn't wanna talk, but the next day I do. The next day my depression is saying, Chris, nobody cares about you, you're gonna be alone, you don't have any friends, your family doesn't care, and all sorts of stuff, right? So that's why it's important to do follow-ups. What you will see when you start to do this is that the person with the depression is actually going to start reaching out to you more often. They might tell you, hey, I'm struggling today. Hey, it's a rough day. Like, that's the goal. That's what we want to happen. We want the person with depression to start being a little bit more proactive and reaching out to you and things like that. And, you know, they might get annoyed that maybe you called them twice in a week, which isn't too crazy. And just remind them to say, hey, you know, I'm just concerned. I just wanna be here for you if I can be, okay? So it's this game of balance where you have to check in but not be overbearing. And you know your friend or family member better than anybody else. So gauge them, see where they're at. Remember to follow up. Don't just like take that one time they don't wanna talk and say, well, fine, I'm just never gonna ask them how they're doing again. Don't be a baby. Follow up with them, all right? So anyways, I would love to hear from all of you. If any of you have ever struggled with depression, even if you went through a bout of being depressed, do me a favor and leave some comments down below. What has your friends or family done for you that has helped you with your depression? Leave them down in the comments, okay? But anyways, again, it's Mental Health Awareness Month. Let's try to help people learn how to help others who are struggling with depression. Please, please, please go out and share this video on social media, all right? But anyways, that's all I got for you today. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you are new here, I'm always making content to help you out with your mental and emotional well-being. Make sure you click that little round subscribe button. If you wanna see some more content, you can click or tap right there. All right, so thanks again so much for watching. Increase awareness, and I'll see you next time.